Commissioner, thank you for being here with us in San Francisco. You're here for the Global Climate Change Summit. What are your expectations and what would be the European ask?
Well, our expectation is the outcome of this summit will give the world a signal that we have to act fast and implement all the commitments that we established under the Paris Agreement. We have to decarbonize the sooner the better, develop countries faster, but also developing countries, and all of us should increase the level of our ambition. And to see that what civil society, what entrepreneurs, what companies, what innovators are doing is extremely important. So for me, this is a unique experience outside of the United Nations traditional framework, because it shows the vigor of the civil society and all the initiatives that are currently ongoing. This call for action, this call for ambition, will be a very important one.
In terms of European priority, in terms of energy, transportation, what they are?
Our biggest priority is to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. That's pretty clear. We had a target of 40% of reduction in 2030, and we have put legislation in place that will allow us not only to fulfill that target, but probably to overshoot this target. So we are working on that. And probably the most difficult thing we will have to do to achieve this reduction of emissions is decarbonize the transport sector. Because there we have established very high standards for reducing CO2 emissions for cars and light vans. For the first time, we will put a standard for heavy-duty vehicles, and we will establish incentives for zero and low-emission vehicles in order to electrify transport. For that, we'll have to develop charging infrastructure on one side, and also we will have to try to develop a platform, European platform, to support development of batteries within the European Union to make them cheaper, affordable, and long-lasting.
How startup company can help to achieve the goals of the you have in European agenda, and how European Commission can support startups in this effort?
In many ways, because we are dealing with the overhaul of our electricity system. We have to have a smart grid, we have to have a smart meter, we have to have demand response, and consumers could use all the technologies to adjust the consumption to the current prices and to balance the grid. We also have to develop technologies in energy efficiency, in eco-design, digitalizing all our grids. So there are many, many fields in the fields of cyber security to protect our installations, our grids, and our networks. So there are many fields, and also in the field of how you electrify transport, how you develop more performant electric motors, how you develop new generations of batteries, how you develop new techniques to stock energy, how to manage better hydrogen. There are so many areas in which technologies developed in Silicon Valley in innovation can support this process. I'm pretty sure that we, the politicians, will establish ambitious targets and the right signals, but I'm sure that innovation will go faster than the legislation we produce, and that the decarbonization of the world will be done faster and cheaper due to the capacity of innovation humankind has.
In Silicon Valley, there is a huge debate, and probably it's the first time in history that startup and innovative company are really looking at regulation, because regulation might in a certain way prevent, might in a certain way route innovation. And so I think GDPR is a strong example of that, mm-hmm. And specifically Europe probably is having a really more and more central role. So there is a huge responsibility for regulators to and have a big role into this process. How do you see that?
But I think regulation has to incentivize developments and not has to block them and stop them. It has to protect citizens. And we are in a moment in which we are in a civilization who handles millions of data simultaneously, and we have to engineer protection for consumers, but also we have to engineer regulations that facilitate development, facilitate innovation, and facilitate all kind of ways to develop ideas to have access to the market and make this access done in the fast track. It's a complex exercise, because you can overregulate and then you stop things, or you can deregulate and then there can happen nasty accidents. It's a big discussion with cryptocurrencies and so on that we are dealing now, and big discussions all over the countries in the world.
So you just landed. What are your first impressions of Silicon Valley?
It's as I expected. I expected this kind of informal, but passionate kind of innovate. So it's the same thing. You don't need very big, beautiful establishments, but it's practical things in which people can work 24 hours a day and develop ideas. It's as I had imagined. The thing I was not so much aware is the huge distance between startups and scale-ups in the US, in the United States and Europe. We have a long way to go.
But we're on the right path. Welcome to San Francisco.
I hope so. Thank you.